Very good afternoon to everyone, all the past participants and the jury members. Myself, Deepika Dubey, I am a research scholar at MIT University, Gurgaon. And I will be presenting my topic, Handwriting Discriminability of Hindi Medium and English Medium Students, a Comparative Approach. So here we go. As we all know, handwriting is an acquired skill. And according to an American article, It is a presentation of person's personality, and it is a pictorial expression of his or her personality, and it is also called the graphic personality of a writer. And some of the books and some of the researchers have also referred it as a perpetual motor task, which means because the handwriting is an act of writing which occurs due to the coordination of brain and muscles. So can we move to the next slide, please? So the aim of my study was to access the handwriting characteristics which were most prominently found in the handwriting of students studied in English medium and Hindi medium students boards. So and to study the significant if there is any difference between the handwritings of both the mediums of the students. And for this purpose, I have set a null hypothesis and used chi-square test to study find the difference. Is that whether there is any significant difference between handwriting of students studied in Hindi medium and English medium students or not. So, ma'am, next slide, please. So, handwriting examination or forensic handwriting examination is basically done on the basis of two basic principles. First is law of individuality, which explains that no two persons can write exactly alike. Hence, the handwriting of a person is unique. And it defines individuality of a person's handwriting. And second is law of progressive change, which defines that the handwriting of a person changes with the passage of time. Next slide, please, ma'am. And along with these individual and along with these laws, there are 13 factors that also affect the development of a handwriting of the person. And some of them are the education of the one of the most prominent factors is education of the person, because the education forms the initial education is the initial training of that person, which has great impact on developing any individual's handwriting. And it also depends on the person's observation capacity and graphic expression and technical execution of the writer. The initial education of a person helps in development of handwriting characteristics and writing habits, which are used for forensic handwriting examination. And these characteristics are class and individual characteristics. So class and individual characteristics forms the basis of forensic examination, which is used in this research also. So the methodology that was used to collect the samples and to carry on this research is as this. The first sample was collected, and the sample size was total in 150 individuals of Hindi medium and 50 individuals of English medium were chosen, and the age range was between 18 to 35, and there was a prescribed pro forma to collect the samples. And ma'am, please can you go back on the previous slide? There was a described pro forma and a paragraph that they have to write. So on the basis of that pro forma and the samples they have written, there were 15 features that were extracted to examine to carry on the study. And ma'am, next slide, please. And these 15 characteristics were abbreviations, embellishments, headings, whether they are centrally aligned or on the left or right side of the paragraph, the cursivity in their handwriting, the punctuation marks, whether they are using the correct punctuation marks at correct places or not. And there were certain formation of letters that were studied. And the formation of letters that were studied are shown in the next slides. So first was placing of dots over the letter I. So whether they are using a dot or a circle, and then curved stroke formation of letter E. In next slide, we can see the curved uppermost horizontal stroke of letter T. Then we have loop or hook loop formation in the lower part of letter F. Then we have loop or hook formation in the lower part of letter S. and round top formation of letter A, and loop in the stem formation of letter B and D. So on the basis of study of observing these characteristics in the handwriting samples, the frequency of occurrence and percentage of these characteristics were studied, which is shown in the table in the next slide. So this table represents the occurrence of these characteristics in English medium students. So here we can see the loop formation in the lower part of letter F was found in 40 out of 50 students of English medium. And there was the correct use of punctuation marks was done by 39 students out of 50. So there were few, these are the few characteristics that were studied, and some prominent ones were which shows most variation, most difference between the both the medium of students were loop formation in the lower part of letter F. Then we have cursivity. Out of 50, there were 34 English medium students who used to write in cursive writing, and only 8 students were there who used to write cursive writings. And the artistic ability was also one of the most prominent factors, which shows that 28 students out of 50 were have the artistic ability, who had studied in English medium, and there were only 2 students who used artistic ability, who used to write artistically in their paragraph in the samples. And the correct use of punctuation marks were also one of the prominent factors, which shown that there were 39 English medium students who had who used the correct punctuation marks, and there were only 10 students of Hindi medium who had used the correct punctuation marks in their paragraph. And the round top formation of letter A was also one of the most prominent factors, which shown that only 5 of the English medium students had used the round top formation of on letter A, there were 33 students who used to write A with round top formation on letter A. Other than these, there are some few other characteristics as well, which can be shown, which is seen in the graph. Ma'am, next slide, please. And next, ma'am, on the comparison part. So to compare and to find to found whether there is any difference or not, the chi-square test was performed, and the chi-square test was calculated manually for each characteristics. So since there was less time, only 10 minutes of time was given, so I was unable to include the whole table that I used to calculate for the chi-square test. So for the purpose of comparison and to study this chi-square test was used, the value for all 15 characteristics I had calculated manually were found to be greater than 3.841, which is a tabulated value. We can also call it p-value, which is used to study whether there is any significant difference in the collected data or not. And it was found to be less. Previous slide, please. It was found to be less than 3.841. So the null hypothesis that we had set in the starting was rejected, and the alternative hypothesis was accepted, which means there is a significant difference between the handwritings of students of English medium and Hindi medium school. Next slide, ma'am. So this is the same part that lower part of the loop formation in the lower part of F was the most significant character in the in English medium students, and this was not most frequently seen in the Hindi writings of Hindi medium students. Ma'am, next slide, please. So the study was the aim of the study was to find whether there was any difference between the handwriting of both the medium of students, and whether the education medium of education impacts the handwriting of the individuals. So through this study, it was found that yes, there was a significant impact of the medium of education on the handwriting of a person. Thank you.